Hello everybody, thank you for being here. So the collection, it's always very comfortable, very flexible, very versatile. And this time, my inspiration is the Indian Mogra flower. It's something we've seen since childhood growing up, and it's very Indian and close to my heart, so that's the inspiration this time. The garments are very relaxed, the silhouettes are relaxed, very wearable, inspired by the wings of the butterfly. Very feminine. Normally the collection is more boho chic, and I wanted to go boho glam this time. So pieces which could be mixed and matched in different ways and worn from day to night. So yeah, it is a very comfortable, versatile collection. The prints are mostly checks and the mogra flower. And the fabrics are very breathable, easy, cottons, tulles. The colors are more pastel, so I think it's perfect for the summer.
So yes, I'm a Putanoi. My collection is called Lost and Found in Africa. So it's been inspired by my travels to Africa. I traveled to Africa in 2015 for about 21 days all alone and backpacked through it. And I did everything possible. I did the safaris and everything. So, you know, what really inspired me there was the colors, the Maasai tribes. I mean, you know, just the beauty of the black skin, you know, Maasai's with that, all those colorful things they do wear. It was more of a visual treat to me than anything. It was more for me to take into and absorb than, you know, what I've given back to the collection. I feel that the beauty cannot be replicated. So you'll see a lot of references to beadwork that you see now wearing, which is there in Africa. It's all glass. And then, you know, the body tattoos and the body piercing rituals, you can see that in my bani that I've used. So I've equated bani to the body tattoos and the piercings with all that silver metallic embroidery that I did. So, you know, it was just, let's see, exploring the electricism of African art with an Indian art. You see a lot of Indian references in the collection as well. I guess that's the... Yeah, so the embellishments are all in glass. They're like katanas and beads. They are in glass, but they have a metallic coating on it. Like piercings are metallic, right? So again, you can see it's almost like a testament for the pain that is born with pleasure. So you see the lip ring and all these. There are 3D embroideries on the garments, because once these people get their skin pierced, which is like completely covering all of it, it kind of gets raised. So, you know, we raised our embroideries a little bit to show that side of piercing. And I also got my hair done right after. Anything else, anyone? So as I said, it's African art with an Indian art. So you see a lot of references to India, because I felt that, you know, I felt very close to the country in terms of culture, in terms of, you know, just the colors, what it has to offer. There are so many crafts. And I felt that the cuts had to be more from me, you know, like, so you see a lot of drapes which are there in the Maasai tribe what they wear as well. And there are a lot of references to India, because there were a lot of crafts which were similar to India. So that's how I related both the countries together.
Window pane checks is something I use in a lot of collections of mine, and I think they kind of remind me like windows to the sky, since my collection is always inspired by everyday life and things that surround us. And checks, they're great for office wear as well as going out in the night. You can wear them with just a dress, and wear checks with just a dress, and it looks good for the night as well. So I think it's a very versatile print. And the other print is the Mogra flower, and the embroidery is 3D butterflies done in pop neon colors, sequin colors. So it almost looks like the interaction between flowers and butterflies. So it is a very springy collection.